Welcome back to Spindling with Sarah and Ashley from How to Spin Yarn. This tutorial is going to cover how to drop spindle a Rolag, which is a great beginner fiber method because it's already pre-drafted. So if you watch the first video where I was pulling the roving apart, basically, you don't have to worry about that step, so it's super easy. These Rolags came from Classy Squid Fiber Company. She is amazing. She makes awesome colorways. Check out her link. It's on my contributors page. Let's get started. How would you do this?
I would pick an end.
Pick an end. What end are you going to do?
I will do black.
Okay, I'll do white. Black.
All right.
I'm going to start with this end. And I still have some yarn here from when we were showing you how to spindle roving. So I'm just going to attach my Rolag to my roving. I'm going to fluff up the ends.
Yeah.
So it's nice and fluffy. And then get a little bit of this fluffiness and pinch them together. And then as I pinch, spin it in a clockwise direction. Have you ever drop spindled Rolag before?
Mm-hmm.
I've never machine spun. I've never done this. I have no idea what I'm doing. So I think the thing that makes Rolags super awesome is that it's really easy, as I get in your face, it's really easy to make like an even, consistent yarn with this fiber as a beginner. So if you really want that traditional look, get some Rolags and practice with Rolags. It's amazing you can just draft for days.
It just keeps coming.
It makes me look so good at this. If you want to impress people at a sheep and wool festival, get a Rolag. This is how you look like you know what you're doing.
It's very rewarding.
It is. I feel very pompous right now.
And it's easier to hold too because it doesn't get caught. You just sling it over your shoulder,
yes,
or something.
You're like Rapunzel.
Yep, there you go.
I feel like I'm like my Rolag's like the Kraken. Like it's like a boa constrictor or something.
Plus it just feels nice to draft.
It does.
It's so smooth and silky.
I think I'm learning something. I think I'm learning that one of the reasons that I haven't been a huge fan of drop spindling is maybe I haven't been using spindle-friendly fiber. Mm-hmm. I think that's like a huge deal. Mm-hmm. I think you have to use spindle-friendly fiber, fiber that naturally spins effortlessly with a spindle. To make it an enjoyable experience. Because I feel like as a spindler, I feel like I'm fighting with fiber all the time.
Gotcha. Yeah, this is pretty mindless.
Yeah.
It's just so easy to draft.
So I'm going to play with different parking methods, I guess. So you can, I guess, like... You can twist and then park, and then all of this twist that comes up here, you can, like, bring it back. Mine's getting all chunked up. Oh, do I need to spread all of this out?
So usually what I'll do is so I'll spin up to a certain point and then kind of, like, just fluff it back down and do it back in.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But, yeah, it kind of chunks up. That's
yeah.
Okay. Oh, that's pretty.
Isn't that pretty?
Like
yeah.
So you notice.
Yeah, I'm I don't think I would notice what is going on in this fiber if I was at a wheel. I would be spinning it so... Look, I'm going to make a thick and thin section. I'm going to get artsy. Look at this. I wonder if I could make... I wonder if I could make just, like, consistent puffs.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Like, that's... Because this is what I like.
Looks good on the spindle, too.
Oh, it does. Take a beauty shot. Strike a puff. Okay, so to make another puff, what if I draft in the opposite direction? Yeah. Okay, so if I take my fiber and bring it down, because usually drafting we're going up, so if I bring it down and then twist it, I get these amazing slubby, loopy textures. Oh, I love that.
That's really gorgeous.
So, yeah, you pull back and then bring some forward. Now, I'm noticing, and maybe it's just because I'm a beginner, that I do not feel like I have as much control over the texture as I do with the wheel. Like, I can't get consistency. Because I think with the wheel, I'm not having to think about twisting, because my feet are doing the spinning. Whereas this, I have to stop, spin. And so it's like... My hands don't get into a pattern like they do on a wheel.
So what I would do with that is I would spin like a certain length of it, and then at the same certain length, I would add one.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like you can measure it with where your arm is on the spindle.
Yeah, that's how you do
it. That makes sense.
It's a whole new world. So one note, as you're spindling, you want to kind of keep like a cone shape. Is that what you do?
Yeah.
Where you keep it like wide around the base of the whorl and narrow, as opposed to like bringing your yarn all the way like this and then all the way back. You want to keep it like tight and like an ice cream cone.
It helps it spin more evenly, I think.
Yeah. And maybe just with some practice, I would get better at these thick sections.
It looks good though.
I like it. I'm happy with it. Fly happy with it too.
Ooh. Sometimes yarn looks so good on a spindle, I'll just keep it on there for a while, like display it on the spindle.
Do a beauty shoot.
Beauty shoot.
Another thing to learn if you're spinning yarn and you're doing like a thick and thin type of thing like this is that twist collects in thin places. So if you have a really puffy area of fiber, you're going to need to put a lot of twist, and you're going to end up, the section that's the thinnest right here is going to end up over twisted, which is fine, but that's just how, in order to secure those puffy pieces, you're going to have to over twist the really skinny pieces. Okay. Done. I win.
You win. Wow.
I win.
So
that is how you drop spindle a Rolag. Yeah. Cheers. Happy spindling.